And then please, a very warm round of applause for your matron of honor tonight. That was fantastic. All right, it's time to get to Chris, our best man. Let's make some noise for him.
How's it going, everybody? So, let's just be honest. I'm not the best man in the room. Dominic is the best man. Let's give him a round of applause. Dominic Kelly. I had a nice stranger bring help lined up for Netflix, but the officiant probably, so that's that.
Yeah.
But really what it comes down to is I've known Dom for about, what, 26, 27 years, so I do have a lengthy speech. I timed it, it's about a minute 30. But it's really funny when I start to look back at all of the things that we've been through in life. You know, we've known each other since we were 12, 13 years old. And, you know, I met Dom in an ice cream shop. You could tell, right? All right. So we were playing Street Fighter 2, and we just kind of like, we just really hit it off. So we decided that it was like, you know, let's just start hanging out. You know, we were kids from the neighborhood. I didn't really know anybody because I went to school out of district. So we tried going like fishing down an Acme pond and realized that sucked. And so we should really just start sticking to video games and things that we were really into. You know, we were into music and, you know, everything. I lost my place. Look at this. All right. But we started doing normal things like fishing and acupuncture, like I said. Bombing down hills on old car hoods. I don't know if you've ever done that. That's a lot of fun in the snow. And then it escalated to different things like taking Alyssa. Where is she? Alyssa, where did you go?
I'm here.
Oh, she's right up here. Great idea. We put Alyssa in a shopping cart in front of a fire hydrant one time. And then we decided we were going to launch her across the street, but it really just washed her down the road. How's your arm? Your broken arm?
Sprained.
Yeah, it was really good. That was a great thing. But some of my greatest memories were just growing up at the Mancino house. You know, playing video games, building remote control cars, and following everything Cornhusker football. I learned all about the Cornhuskers. And did you know that Dom is a descendant of Alexander Hamilton? The founding father, right? Do we know this? So when Dom is really getting into these crazy Facebook rants, okay, political Facebook rants, he's got some cred, okay? But all my whiskey friends, where are the whiskey drinkers? All right, Alexander Hamilton passed the first whiskey pack, so you can take it up with him. And I want Dom in the next Ancestry.com commercial, so Dad, please take care of that and start helping out there. Please. So, you know, but some of the best memories is like a true founding father family. 4th of July at the Mancino house is always just a crazy, crazy event. A garage loaded with fireworks that obviously pretended to be arrested. Never happened. But, you know, certain father would always, you know, develop a switch box that could light off, you know, crazy fireworks, especially in front of the police. That was always awesome when they pull up and then these big explosions would happen. The best memory actually was there was a rocket one time I took off and got it in the air, turned around and shot back down through the roof of the neighbor's car. The rag top burned it to the ground. It burned down. Yeah. And then we all had a family, we all just kept the fire out. But that's how I knew I was in. I was in then. We all kept our mouths shut until today, 26 years later, that we don't do that. But just going back to some of the things. It was an antique, yes, it was. Past tense. But it also just spoke to, like, you know, with Big Dom making that switch box, really just spoke to, like, even the technical things that Dom does. Everybody knows Dom is a computer genius, car genius. That comes from his father, that comes from his grandfather, Lyle, who's out here with us today, who is just an awesome, awesome person. He's very influential in his life. You know, Dom was the guy who just really wants to sit next to him on the bus. He should sit down on the bus, and he'd have a surround sound system, just build out of nothing. Hooked into the bus. It was great. He was the guy in the car. These are my spots here. But, you know, even though he's younger and shorter than me, he's someone to look up to. So in high school, I don't know if you all know this, Dom won the perfect attendance award. Did you know this? The perfect attendance award. I was a close second. We never wanted to be those guys where their mother had to go to school and make sure they went to class. We never wanted to do that person. Who would want to do that? At his valedictorian speech, he graduated top of his class. At that speech, he dedicated it to safe driving and anti-street racing. And he really, he was was always known for his patient conflict resolution. Yes, incredible skills. But if that's not enough, he's also a giver. Sometimes he's a giver of headaches, but yes. But usually giving the shirt off his back or the last dollar his pocket, which we can all attest to. He is, without a doubt, the greatest person you could ever know. He'll chase you down to make sure everything's okay and if there's anything you need. And sometimes he can feel like he's going overboard. But in all honesty, it was an event actually with talking about going overboard, which really made me appreciate Dominic is laughing right now. But really, looking back, it really wasn't big. It was really scary. When we were about 13, we were on my parents' boat, and we were going out in the harbor, and this big boat just rode past us. It made this huge, huge wave. Dom and I were in the front, and we were really excited. It was awesome. This wave washed over us, and I held on, and also Dom go overboard. I mean, Dom. And it sounds funny, but it really wasn't, because he couldn't really swim. And he was gone. And we couldn't find him for about 5 minutes. And literally, it was the scariest moment in like my life at that moment. He doesn't pop up. My uncle picks him up on board, and he hears. He said, "What was the exact word you heard? You hit your head twice, and you heard." He heard the propeller go right past his head, and everybody just wanted to throw up. Because it could have lost him. It was really a horrible, horrible experience. But it makes me think back to all of his times. But it's not meant to change everything in his life, and he's been the better for it, and I love you from the minute I met you. Just even like today, case in point, we get on, there's a list of everything that Dom needs to do. Everything's lifted out for him, and she's just on top of everything for him. It's just right at the minute. He gets on the bus, brings the dog, we take the trolley here, and as we pull up, he goes, "Was I supposed to bring the dog? Was the dog supposed to be here?" but he needs you, and he does need you. We need you. And thank you for being there for him. You have a great husband. He's my best friend. We all love everyone in this room. So I just want to say toast to Dom and Kelly, for all our family members that are not here today, that are here in spirit, that are here celebrating with us. Cheers.
Let's make some noise, please, for those fantastic speeches, especially our best man.